DTPA, or diethylene triamine pentaacetate, is a prescription medication that is FDA approved for treatment of internal contamination with plutonium, americium, and curium. DTPA comes in two forms or salts, calcium DTPA and zinc DTPA. Calcium DTPA is 10 times more effective when given as the single initial dose. All subsequent doses should be changed to zinc DTPA. Well, DTPA passes through the body virtually unchanged. However, calcium DTPA is such a strong chelator that it can deplete body stores of zinc, magnesium, and manganese. Therefore, caution should be used in patients who have other diseases that may be related to different levels of zinc and metabolism of zinc, as well as impaired renal function and in pregnancy. Treatment in pregnancy is almost always with the zinc DTPA form. Women who are internally contaminated with any of these radioisotopes should not breastfeed. There are many different ways to get rid of internal contaminants. Chelation is one of those. Chelation actually is derived from the Greek word chela, meaning claw. So think of an arcade game where a claw is picking up one metal more so than other metals, and then it drops and gets rid of that metal. Calcium DTPA is such a strong chelator that it can deplete the body of stores of zinc, magnesium, and manganese. Dosage with DTPA for adolescents and adults is 1 gram slow IV push given daily. Remember that the first dose in most cases should be calcium DTPA, with subsequent doses being zinc DTPA. For children under 12 years of age, the dosage is 14 milligrams per kilogram, not to exceed 1 gram, slow IV push given daily.